It's been a bit since I've talked about games in particular, but I thought about a scene recently from a certain game that I've played that really makes me think after seeing it. And it does this to me every time. The scene that I am talking about is called It's Me from The Last of Us. In particular, The Last of Us Part 1, as it's now known. Now, I'm kind of one to agree that The Last of Us shouldn't have gotten a sequel, even though I'm playing the second one, and I think it's fine. I've had 5 hours with Part 2, and some things I have to say, the melee combat is improved. But the lines between Dina and Ellie are stupid as fuck sometimes. But that's not what we're gonna discuss. What we're gonna discuss is the scene from the scene It's Me. Now, for context, for those of you that haven't played the game, which I'll be decently surprised if you haven't played or seen it, this is the climax of the winter scene in the game. Or the winter, like, time period. It's when you play as Ellie for majority of it, and you've met David and his friend, who, unbeknownst to you up until a certain point later, that he is part of a group of cannibals that have actually sabotaged, or not sabotaged, but ambushed you earlier in the game. And it's when Ellie goes pretty brutal, but she's also very vulnerable. I'm gonna play the scene right now, and then I'll tell you why it's gotten me to think. Yeah, it's quite a decent amount to unpack there. Now, the main thing is, now of course, Ellie is brutal as hell in that scene. She butchers the hell out of David's head with a machete. But the part that strikes me a lot, as well as I'm sure everybody, or most people that have seen that scene, is when Joel's there. And he's trying to calm Ellie down, and then you see Ellie breaking into tears after that. It's something that hits me hard, and the reason that I'm saying that is because I'm thinking of being a father somewhere down the line. And two ways. Either I'm with somebody that I love in the future, and we both agree to have a kid, or I'm still single by then and I choose to adopt somebody. This, however, has two things that come into account. One, I just mentioned, I'm on my own by the time I move out and I'm able to sustain myself. And the other one is if I'm with a partner and she decides that, or we both agree on that as well. Because parenthood is something that I never really considered up until last year, potentially 6 months ago at most. And the more I think about it, the more appealing it kind of gets. But the scarier it is to think, what if a scenario like that happens? Like, what if there's a scenario where something really traumatic happens, or my child potentially just goes off very aggressively, and you're supposed to comfort them and tell them that everything is going to be fine? You know, it's these kinds of situations that really make you think and make you question how things could go moving forward. But even knowing that, I'm still determined to get to that point in the future. But it's just going to take some time. So it's just something that I've wanted to talk about, and it's something that I might possibly draw about as well, because like I said, parenthood gets more and more interesting to me the more that I think about it, and maybe even the more that I talk about it. But you know, it's just something that most people might think about once they reach this stage, perhaps. And this also goes to show how good The Last of Us is, because the themes about parenthood and having a second chance at something, it's things that stick with you. And that's one reason why I believe, as well as others perhaps, that the game deserves to have massive praise, even 9 years later. So, yeah. It's just something that popped in my head as of recently. It's probably going to resonate with me for a good while too, perhaps. But, you know, it's just something that I wanted to share. So, yeah. I'll see everyone around.